Greetings everyone, my name is Bife here. So, I wanted to use this video as a sort of general update type thing because over the last 10 days or so I've had quite a few reasonable questions asked by all of you guys who are watching. So, before we get to the one that's actually in the thumbnail, I want to start with one that is at the very top of all of the questions and is actually potentially just as important as the other one. And that is as follows. Hey, Bife, are you going to stop making Destiny content so you can make Monster Hunter content instead? The answer is one where I feel like I need to drive a few very important points home to make myself clear. These are two games that I have loved for a very long time. Seriously, these are incredible franchises and I don't think I can properly state that well enough. I will make content for both. I want to teach you all how to become better hunters and I also want to make you wiser guardians. I think people are set in this mode of existential crisis when they hear that I'll be making content for another game no matter what that game is, but I want you all to really quickly remember what games are supposed to be about, and that's fun. And the honest truth is that there's a lot of fun to be had in both games. I know that there's going to be a cynical section of the audience that will be rolling their eyes right now, but Destiny's raids and stories are still of great entertainment and inspiration to me. And in the Monster Hunter world, the expeditions and hunts that you go on are also incredibly fun. I enjoy both, and I want to show all of you why. Right now, Destiny is going through a bit of a transformative period, and I for one am glad to see that even the next expansion is being delayed until May. This is going to give Bungie a little bit more time to make the game something better to play, and the great point about that is that it's giving us a moment where we can rightly take a break from it if we need to. In my mind, Destiny has always had off-seasons and on-seasons. Right now, I think it's fair to say that we're going through a bit of an off-season, and that's not just from the current state of the game, considering how Destiny 2 launched, no. I'm saying that primarily because of the fact that there's not much content around the corner either. In terms of events, we have Crimson Days coming up, but honestly, there's not much else to Crimson Days. It's just going to be a new loot pool, a look at how the new microtransaction system is going to work, and hopefully a look at how it could be done better, and something else which is going to be a new game mode or two. Maybe something which is reprised from the old Destiny. And honestly, that's kind of it. There's not much more to be said about Destiny at this exact moment in time. Am I still going to play Destiny every week? Yeah, of course. But I'm also going to be playing Monster Hunter, and right now, that game has a lot of content, and it's honestly something that I really enjoy. So, yeah, I am going to be doing both, and I hope people can understand why that is. If you aren't having fun in your current game, try another. It's a principle that I've always stuck to. And to be clear once more, I'm not saying abandon Destiny or leave it for dead or throw it to the wind and say that all of a sudden I've quit Destiny YouTubing, because I know that this is something that people have a tendency to say the minute that people make videos like this. No, not the case. Stop. Enough. Meh. We don't need that. To be clear once more, Destiny is not something that I'm abandoning. What I am simply saying is play games that you have fun with, and that playing games should be fun. This is a statement that best summarizes the whole Destiny vs. Monster Hunter situation in my mind. Alternatively, I could just, you know, throw up that one why not both gif that everyone already uses around at this point, but, you know, I don't think that's good enough for a kind of well-constructed argument. The point I'm really trying to make here is, don't panic. If you like my content, it's not going anywhere. If you like stuff that's new and you really want to get into Monster Hunter, I'm going to expand stuff for you. But I'm also going to try and make things a little bit better in terms of my current schedule, because honestly, things fell apart over the last month or so, and that's purely because of the fact that, honestly, I did not know what I was going to talk about. That lack of content in Destiny means that it's getting harder to make videos, and it's not something where you can always relate back to the news of Destiny, because honestly, I don't necessarily know if I enjoy talking about news as much. There is the series that I want to continue about critiquing Bungie and critiquing Destiny, but the nice thing about that is it's a series that I don't know if I have to continue for as long as I need to. And that's purely based on the fact that Bungie is already addressing quite a lot of critiques. The recent Sandbox video where they went through and talked about the speeds of all the Guardians in PvP and how they're reworking Warlock jumps and everything around that, it shows promise, and I don't know if I necessarily need to make those videos because I may be making small points that are falling on deaf ears. So, yeah, I don't know if it's 100% necessary. I'm still gonna make them, assuming that things haven't been properly addressed yet, but yeah, I think I'm in a state where I don't need to do that as much, and that's maybe a lucky thing. The two that I've done thus far on the archive and Bungie's communication problem, though, I still think are relevant, so of course if you want to go ahead and catch up on those and see what my commentary to Bungie is, you'll kind of get an idea of what that series is meant to be. As for Monster Hunter content, there is another big question that everybody is going to be asking, and this is the one which is actually at the very top of the video. Bife, are you considering making lore videos for Monster Hunter? This one is actually a really interesting question for a few reasons. I want to begin it by saying maybe sliding towards probably not. And the reasons why are actually really important. One of them is that you guys expect a certain level of quality from my lore videos. You expect a certain amount of expertise. Expertise that I do not have, in spite of playing multiple previous Monster Hunter games. You will understand why I don't have that, though, with the fact that most Monster Hunter veterans don't have much knowledge on it, because honestly, the story in the game is not up to much. It's honestly much more about the monsters you face and the world that you're in than the human side of the story, or the, well, Palico side of the story. I can't really say human side when it's a society of cats as well. Kind of weird like that. Anyway, the whole point is that even if I look back through previous Monster Hunter games with you guys, you'll start to realize that the campaign in Monster Hunter has always been exceptional because of the monsters and because of the challenge. It's not been story-driven in the sense that you have some overarching objective or plot theme. Monster Hunter World is actually the standout exception because it has a significantly better story-driven campaign than most other Monster Hunter games. So, that's the real change there. Lore always has to start from the foundation of the basic story told in the world. For Monster Hunter, that just doesn't get talked about enough in-game. There's some stuff to talk about in the notion of the Sapphire Star and the Five Fleets and the entire idea of colonizing the New World and why Monster Hunter World is set in this entirely different continent across the Dark Sea, but I honestly don't know if there's enough there for me to make any content. And certainly not an expansive amount to the extent that I've made it in Destiny. And you know what? That's a real shame, because the world here is seriously phenomenal, with amazing potential. Now, aside from that, I think it should be made really clear that there is lore in Monster Hunter, but there's a problem here with that as well. Most of the lore is told through developer interviews that have been published throughout the years. This is fine in itself, but it presents an entirely different problem. To start off with, most of these are made originally in Japanese, the interviews that is. And amazingly enough, the fact that it's a different language that I do not know is not even the problem, not slightly. Translations of many of these articles and interviews will exist. So, that's not the problem. The problem is within the nature of translation itself. To give you an example of what I mean, take a look back at The Last Jedi. The film most recently released on the Star Wars franchise. When the German film title came out, people were whipped into a frenzy because it was slightly different from the English version. You see, in German, words within sentence structures will often carry genders as opposed to ours where they can just entirely be neuter. In German, everything has to be either masculine, feminine, or neuter. This means that, from the simple title of the film, The Last Jedi, people had an idea of who this Last Jedi might be because the term Jedi had to be given a gender. And so now you start to understand how language and translation can change everything. Now, it can be even more extreme when you see how language changes as it's formed out of a Greco-Roman culture in comparison to those born in Japan or China. The cultures are drastically different, for one, but the very simple nature of an alphabet-based language versus one that is based in complex characters can completely muddle the nature of translation. Some words in English quite simply don't exist in Japanese and vice versa, and a single Japanese character can be used to display and portray a very complex idea, whilst in English we'd need half a sentence to say something similar. And again, the word may not exist, so you don't necessarily know if you're getting the entirety of what's being said. And this becomes very important when you're trying to faithfully and accurately discuss the core concepts of the universe. All these factors combined mean that whilst I could probably struggle through the translations quite happily and bring you some lore on the world, I would always worry for its accuracy, and that really would bug me. In short, I'd want not only a skilled translator, but also someone who could assure me that the lore was accurate before I dared to touch the lore of this universe. As a really good example of how this ends up working out, let's take another look at another title that was also developed by a developer in Japan, and that's Dark Souls. Vati Vidya is one of the most prominent YouTubers within that space, and he himself has actually sat down and had a look into how language has changed the lore, and how the original translations have worked wonders in making all sorts of new stories possible. This is really kind of what I'm trying to get to. I don't have the same resources that Vati has, and I don't think the game is built in the same way to bring the story to life through its world and through its lore. Monster Hunter is an incredible game, but just not for that same reason. Now, why did I say all of this and state that there was a maybe to this lore? Well, whilst I don't necessarily dare touch the lore of this universe, which I would consider as sacred as Destiny's or Dark Souls, without knowing it, I do know quite a bit about the monsters we're fighting, and there's something in that which might still be quite palatable to you guys. I played with this idea of doing monster profiles of sorts, a sort of bestiary that gives you all the facts and information you might want about each monster. Think of it as a sort of David Attenborough style of video with a bit more of a narrative focus than one based in pure combat or the gameplay that you're seeing in the background. That's just an idea, but let me know what you think in the comments section down below of that. On that general note of content, I'm going to try and do the following though. One guaranteed Monster Hunter video a week, one guaranteed Destiny video a week, and a third, which is made from whichever game I feel like talking about. In addition, on the weekend, I'm going to be working with my editor to bring you all something different and fun. Recently, I released the first episode of That Sounds Like a You Problem, which is basically a series where I fool around and have fun with my friends. That should be going up most weekends, and it'll round us out to 4 manageable videos every week on this channel. I want to also thank all of you, though, because dedication is a strange thing to talk about on YouTube or Twitch. It is, well, scary often. It's a horrifying time to be a Destiny YouTuber, it's a horrifying time to be any YouTuber, but the support that I've been getting in the last few weeks is still phenomenal. It's amazing to see that you guys are still supporting my channel and keeping my dream job alive. It's comments like, "I don't play Destiny anymore, but I still watch all your videos," that really do keep me going. And that, well, that means quite literally the world to me. It means literally my job. So, thank you. Thank you so much to every single one of you. And I hope that you can still continue to enjoy my content, whether it's Monster Hunter or Destiny or both. In the coming days, I'm going to be talking about some guides that I'm going to be throwing up for Monster Hunter, both endgame and beginning, and I'm also going to be talking about the latest Destiny comic in the Fall of Osiris series. But in the meantime, I hope you guys all approve of the direction I'm going to be taking the channel in for the next few months. And if you do, please do go ahead and hit a like down below. I really would appreciate it. Also, of course, leave your comments on what you thought of that one idea for a monster bestiary series in the comment section as well. I hope that I can get some good feedback on that. If it is, I will absolutely jump in and start doing it. I already have a few ideas. But also, if you want to keep up with any of the content I'm putting on this channel, you can of course always hit the subscribe button. And if you never want to miss a video, you can hit the bell next to subscribe to turn on those email notifications. But of course, all of this, not at all necessary. Your viewership, as I always say, is quite enough for me. So, with that said, thank you all very much for watching. A scary time, as I said, but I know that you guys can all help me get through it. I know we can get through it together as a community, and I'm thankful for every single one of you and the blessings that you have given me in my time here on YouTube that I hope will be continuing for many more years. And in the meantime, my name is Bife. Parodasia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.